85 grams of gold, he or she should give 2.5% of that excess wealth in charity every lunar year. And after that, if any person robs, man or woman, chop off his or her hand as a punishment, I'm asking a question, will the rate of robbery and theft in America, will it increase, will it remain the same, or will it decrease? It will decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia and you get results. That's why I say that Islam, besides speaking good things, it also shows you a way how to achieve the state of goodness. Time may not permit us to go into all the details because of the limited time that I've been given to speak. I'll just give you a couple of more examples. All the major religions say that you should not molest a girl, that you should not rape a woman. Christianity says that. Hinduism says that. Islam says the same. But the difference between Islam and the other religions is, Islam shows you a way how to achieve a stage in which people will not molest or rape any girl. People, mainly the speakers, they talk about hijab for the woman, hijab for the woman, hijab in Islam for women. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the glorious Quran first speaks about the hijab for the man and then for the woman. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 30, say to the believing man that he should lower his gaze and guard his modesty. The moment a man looks at a woman, any brazen thought comes in his mind, he should lower his gaze. There was one of a Muslim brother of ours who was staring at a girl for a long time. So I told him, brother, what are you doing? It's not allowed in Islam. So he told me that a prophet said, the first glance is forgiven, the second is prohibited. I have not completed half my glance. What did the prophet mean when he said the first glance is forgiven, the second is prohibited? That doesn't mean that you look at a girl for 10 minutes without blinking and saying that I haven't completed my glance. That if you unintentionally look at a woman, don't intentionally look at her to feast on her beauty. The next verse speaks about the hijab for the woman. Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 31 says, say to the believing woman that she should lower her gaze and guard her modesty and display not her beauty except what appears ordinary of, and to draw her veil over the bosom except in front of her husband, her father, her son, and a big list of mahram who she's not allowed to marry is given. And the criteria for hijab is given in the Quran, the Sahih Hadith. There are basically six criteria. The first is the extent which differs between the man and the woman. For the man, it's from the navel to the knee. For the woman, the complete body should be covered. The only part that can be seen are the face and the hands up to the wrist. The remaining five criteria are the same. The second is the clothes they wear, it should not be so tight so that it reveals the figure. Third, it should not be transparent so that you can see through. Fourth, it should not be so glamorous so that it attracts the opposite sex. Fifth, it should not resemble that of the unbeliever. And sixth, it should not resemble that of the opposite sex. And the reason for hijab for the woman is given in the glorious Quran in Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 59, which says, O Prophet, tell your wives and the believing women that when they go abroad, they should put on the cloak so that they shall be recognized and it will prevent them from being molested. Suppose two beautiful, equally beautiful, and one of the twin sister, she is wearing the Islamic hijab, complete body covered except the face and the hands up to the wrist, and the other twin sister, she is wearing the Western clothes, mini skirt or shorts. And if they're walking down the streets of Durban, and if round the corner there is a hooligan, there is a hoodlum who's waiting for a catch, who's ready to tease a girl, I'm asking a question, which girl will it tease? Will it tease the girl wearing the Islamic hijab, or will it tease the sister who's wearing the mini skirts and shorts? Quran rightly says that hijab has been prescribed for the woman to prevent her from being molested. And after that, the Islamic Sharia says, if any man rapes any woman, capital punishment, death penalty. Non-Muslims say, death penalty? In this age of science and technology, Islam is a barbaric religion. It's a ruthless law. But when I pose this question to my non-Muslim brothers, and I've posed to thousands of them, that suppose, unfortunately, God forbid, someone rapes your mother or rapes your wife, and if you are made the judge and the rapist is born in front of you, what punishment will you give him? And believe me, all of them said, we will put him to death. Some went to the extreme of saying, we will torture him to death. So why these double standards? Someone rapes your mother, your wife, you want to put him to death, Someone raped somebody else's wife or mother, you say death penalty is a barbaric law. You know, in America, the country which is supposed to be the most advanced in the world, according to the statistics of FBI, 1990, in the year 1990 alone, 102,555 cases of rape took place. And the report said only 16% were reported. So for the complete figure, you have to multiply by 6.25 and you get a total of 640,968 rapes that took place in America in 1990. If you divide by 365 the number of days, you get an average of 1,754 cases of rape that took place every day on average in the year 1990 alone. The other statistics of 1996, the U.S. Department of Justice, Crime Bureau, it says on average every day 2,713 cases of rape took place in the year 1996. 1990, 1,756, 54, and in 1996, 2,713. Maybe the Americans got more bold. And the 1996 statistics says every 32 seconds, one case of rape is taking place. You know, we have been here for the past half an hour. Already, 60 rapes may have taken place in America from the time we are here in this auditorium. 60 rapes may have already been taking place. I am asking you the question that if you implement the Islamic Sharia in America, that is, every man, when he looks at a woman, any unashamed thought, any brazen thought comes in his mind, he should lower his case. And the woman, her complete body should be covered, except the face and the hands up to the wrist. And after that, if any man rapes a woman, capital punishment. I'm asking the question, will the rate of rape in America, will it increase? Will it remain the same or will it decrease? It will decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia and you get results. That is the reason I say that Islam, besides teaching good things, shows you a way how to achieve the state of goodness. All the major religions, theoretically, they speak about universal brotherhood. But Islam is the only religion which practically implements it in its day-to-day life. And this country, as we all know, previously there was the apartheid law. Now it has been abolished, again theoretically, but practically it yet is there in most of the people living here. Islam has the solution. And I start my talk by quoting a verse from the glorious Quran, from Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49, verse number 13, which says, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min zakrin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lit'arafu inna akramakum indallahi atqakum innallaha alimun khabir. O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you shall recognize each other, not that you shall despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Allah who has taqwa. The criteria for judgment in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not caste, it's not color, it's not sex, it's not wealth, it is taqwa. It's God consciousness, it's piety. And in Islam, we practically demonstrate universal brotherhood minimum 5 times every day. I'm referring to the salah. When we offer salah, our beloved Prophet said, it's mentioned in Sunnah Abu Dawud, volume number